Hey guys, it has been a while since I last uploaded anything really. As you can read the title, recently I am kind of addicted to mechanical keyboard stuff, and I just really wanted to share my experience about this mechanical keyboard. So let me tell you a little on how I got into this hobby. Okay, so it started off as me wanting to get a keyboard for my PC. So I searched online, went through some video on YouTube, and I really wanted a budget keyboard, but I don't want a Razer keyboard because they are way too overpriced. And I started searching them, and I ended up with an RK Royal Clutch 84, which is really nice because I wanted a wireless keyboard and it's really nice. But then, after I received the RK 84, I never stopped watching those videos. In fact, I watched even more of them. And that is how I basically got into the rabbit hole. Until it was time for my birthday, my friends asked me what I wanted for the birthday gift. At first, I said that I wanted a battle pass for my Genshin Impact game. But then I started to think about it, then I think that maybe I want a more physical thing to commemorate this. So I searched online and just to find some budget switches, which I ended up with Echo Blue Switch, Ocean Blue Switches, which are tactile, which I like, and really smooth and really, most importantly, budget. And then I also asked my dad to buy me a lubing kit to lube my switches, and basically that is how I got into this hobby. So now it's about time for me to share my experience while modding my Royal Clutch 84 keyboard. So one of the first things that I did was to unscrew everything, to disassemble everything, so I can clean my plate and also the stabilizer. Because I've been using it for a while, it is pretty dirty as you can see. And the foam that you see in the video is my first time trying to mod a keyboard. I put some foam that I found randomly in my home and just place it in so it will reduce the hollowness of it. I also try to fine-tune the stabilizer wire just like Wildcat, but I think it is pretty okay stocked already, so that's just my opinion, okay? I was going to do the holy mod since my stabilizers were really rattly, but then I realized that it took too much time and I also got the wrong plaster. So I skipped the whole holy mod and I just cut off the excess stem on the stabilizer stem, and it did remove some of the mushiness I had with the stabilizers. After that, I also relooped all my stabilizers since the stock one was pretty bad, and I also placed some plaster over the socket of the stabilizers, which I think it helps prevent it to rattle as much. I say it's pretty good now. For switches, I got Echo Ocean Blue switches since I wanted something tactile and smooth and in the budget range. I only got 45 of them because I don't think I actually need that much of the switches, because I only mainly use like less than 30 of the keys, so I think the rest I will just use it stock. The stock switches are Royal Clutch proprietary brown switches, which are really bad and they are really scratchy as well, even after lubing them. After that, I also realized that I can do the tape mod, and I did. I wouldn't say it's a big difference, but it did make my keyboard a little poppier. After that, I realized that something is missing. Keycaps. I didn't get the GNK keycaps since they are so expensive, so I got the Dysub keycaps instead. They are good enough for me already. And also, this keyboard is made possible from all the gifts I got from my father, from my mother, and also my friends, which are Leong Hao, Jun Hong, Eric, and also Mei Heng. Thanks to all you guys. Thank you for making my keyboard the way I wanted it. Thank you, everybody. So it's time for the sound test.